All right, so yes, we are back, and yes, I am here to break down the... I forgot the fucking name of the event. Listen, it's not my fault this thing was terribly promoted and you had to transfer your money through some kind of shitcoin cow-cow swap or cocoa bean or whatever the fuck it was just to watch this fight. But it did go down and it featured two names that are somewhat big names in the YouTube boxing scene, Adam Sala and Slim. Adam Sala took on Walid or Waleed, I don't know how to say his name, Sharks. And then Slim fought a guy that looked like Sean O'Malley if you ordered him off of Wish or some third-party website, then slapped some Joker tattoos on him. I don't know who the f*** that dude was. And while Slim looked in shape, he looked ready to go for the fight. It looked like he took it seriously. Adam, on the other hand, looked a little soft. He didn't look as fit as he did the first time we saw him, and just wasn't as trim. And speaking of trims, I'd like to introduce the sponsor for today's video, Manscaped. That's right, guys. Manscaped is back to let you know if your pubes are out of this world, don't worry, because Manscaped has developed a solution in their performance package 4.0. And they got all the tools to get the job done. One in particular that'll glide across your skin with zero nicks and feel like you're in zero gravity is, of course, the Lawnmower 4.0. The 4.0 is a spaceship designed for intergalactic terrain, meaning it can trim everything from your body to your balls, even in the most dire consequences, Uranus. And after a successful mission using your Lawnmower 4.0, you always gotta remember, use your Crop Preserver and your Crop Reviver. These two in conjunction not only keep you protected from that grade A heat, but also keep everything downstairs dry and comfortable. You don't wanna miss out on this deal. Use code WADE at manscaped.com for 20% off and free shipping. Again, that's code WADE at manscaped.com for 20% off and free shipping. Thank you to Manscaped for sponsoring this video, and always remember, for a clean Trinity and beyond, your Spaceballs will thank you, thanks to Manscaped. Now, let's get back to the video. So let's get into it. Adam Sala versus Walid Sharks. Why it was not a draw. Was there some fishy stuff going on? And who actually won this fight? The breakdown, let's go. The first round, Adam comes out like an absolute bat out of hell. The first punch of the fight, Adam comes out with a massive overhand right, and it lands on Walid. I don't think he expected Adam to come forward and really put that pressure on him that early. Watching Adam in those first two or three exchanges, there was a clear strategy he was gonna try to get Walid Sharks out of there early. Adam came forward, he was winging shots, throwing big time overhands. But Walid Sharks is showing great poise for a 17-year-old in that environment. He did show that he belonged in there because he ate some big time shots in that first round, and he had some success. There were times where he did come forward and put Adam on the ropes. And while shots weren't always landing in those positions, yeah, he would rake the body and try to come upstairs, but Adam was doing a good job blocking a lot of those shots by shelling up. But as we do move through the round, outside of Walid pushing Adam up on the ropes and landing to the body a couple shots here and there, a nice left hook he threw sometime in the first round as well, you started to see the more clear and decisive shots, even with this shitty ass camera work. What the f*** are you doing, Social Knockout? More like Social Sunday, because you're just showing f***ing people in the crowd drinking Mai Tais and clapping. Are we at a boxing match or happy hour? Show the f***ing fight. As that round went on, Walid continued to get touched with that overhand right. Adam wasn't throwing it straight down the pipe. He was jabbing to the body with the overhand behind it. Yes, they were wild in nature, but they did land more and more cleanly than a lot of what Walid threw and landed in the first round. This was a close round, but I do think Adam's aggression early on, I think his ability to land shots continuously, not necessarily in combination, but continuously throughout the round. Walid did have success, but as the round ended, I definitely went Adam's way. A close round, but I do give Adam the first. So as we come out for the second, I don't know if Walid sensed that he might have been down in that first round, but the tempo switched. He was now on offense. He wanted to come out firing on Adam, throwing big time shots, and that's what happened. I think at this point, he started to realize Adam is only throwing the jab overhand right when we're at distance. And we've talked about this many times, how your biggest weapon sometimes is also your biggest weakness. You watch Adam throw his big overhand right, and it takes a lot of energy out of him. He was loading that right hand up like I load up a baked potato beside a New York strip. He had everything in that right hand. And because of it and the lack of any kind of creativity, Walid saw what was coming to him, and Adam's gas tank was starting to deplete. Adam allows himself to be on the ropes, and he's trying to rope-a-dope and maybe take a rest as Walid Sharks is throwing combinations, this time to the body, And as he works upstairs, Adam's not catching everything on the hands this round. Instead, that cross is splitting through. Adam drops the hands to protect the body. Left hook over the top. And that was one of the biggest moments in that second round. And of course, as the round goes on, they go back and forth. And again, it's a competitive round. By no means did Adam get starched in this second round at all. He had some moments as well. He had a great left hook off the break, had a straight right hand that clipped Waleed coming in, and had it landed more cleanly, we might have seen someone eat the canvas. So I did give Waleed Sharks the second round. I thought he landed more. I thought he threw more. His output was there. The pressure was there. It was almost like Waleed on the back foot in the first round, maybe a little nervous, maybe just trying to feel out what the power of Adam Sala was. And once he started to get that timing, once he started to see the rhythm of Adam Sala, then that second round was his to try to push that pace back and get that round he probably lost in the first one back. So this is a 1-1 fight heading into the third, but you know that little wave we were talking about at the end of the second round where Adam started to kind of take the back steps and Waleed Sharks on the front foot was really having more success in little spurts? Well, fuck me, you could have called it a damn tidal wave because my man Waleed Sharks transformed into a fucking megalodon and rode that wave downhill and just ate Adam Sala alive in this round. It was pretty surprising to see. Adam was, again, getting pinned on the ropes, and it almost seemed like he accepted being there. It was almost like, ah, you know, I'm playing with this kid, nothing's landing. Well, yeah, things were landing, and those shots on the ropes, they might not have hurt Adam in rounds 1 and 2, right? He was shaking his head. He was like, nah, those don't hurt me. Well, in round 3, I know he was trying to like emulate Muhammad Ali with the white shorts and the black trim, but he got turned into Adam Knocknee because a left hook actually buckles him a tad bit on the ropes as Waleed's coming forward throwing shots. And in this third round, a decisive round, Adam is kind of okay with just letting it happen. And like I said, there are small bursts from Adam, right? There are last gasps here, especially in this third round where he tries to make up some ground even toward the latter part of the round, but it just wasn't enough because both guys, Adam and Waleed, were pretty similarly skilled, right? They were around the same skill level. But, and I say this all the time when we talk about fights, you can weaponize your pace. If you are in better shape than the other guy, when you both have the same technique, but he gets tired first, now you're in the driver's seat. And again, fighters fear fatigue more than they fear any other fighter because you just can't defend yourself and you really start to fall off a cliff. While it is building up and he is landing some big time shots, you hear the announcers trying to tell you what's happening, even though the camera is doing 360 fucking Modern Warfare 3 no scope camera angles. From what we did see in the third round, Waleed Sharks definitely took that round. So as the fight ends, they go to the judges' scorecard, which, by the way, were never announced as to what the actual scoring numbers were. But the judges apparently come to the conclusion of a majority draw, which is damn near almost fucking impossible. There's literally only two reasons this fight could have been a draw, and that is if someone was given a 10-8 round, which none of those rounds were 10-8s. Yes, Waleed Sharks was the clear winner of the third round. He didn't knock Adam down. He wasn't out on his feet to where the referee needed to come in and give him a standing 8. None of that happened. Yeah, the buckle of Adam's leg for a split second, and you could definitely see that, but it wasn't enough to warrant a 10-8 round as Adam did have flurries coming back. And the only other scenario would be if one judge gave a round to Adam, one judge gave a round to Waleed, and then a 10-10 round at some point in the boxing match, which is, again, one of the most rare things you will ever see in boxing, a straight 10-10 round. Or a 9-9, and no one got points taken away, so that couldn't fucking happen. So I don't know what the fuck happened with the judges, if they even gave a shit, or if they just said something to a guy, because again, no scorecards were even read off. They were just like, oh, majority draw, yeah, in a 3-round fight where no one got knocked down or no one was penalized. Makes sense. It doesn't change my mind that Waleed Sharks came and wanted to win this fight, and in my opinion, did that. Yeah, guys, this was a close fight for 2 rounds. Waleed Sharks pulls it out in the third. Like I said, it's not a great look for Adam because over those 6 minutes, he didn't have much left at the end of it. His cardio did not hold up. Not even as much as a guy like Waleed Sharks, who said he trained for a month. To be honest, I don't know what Adam should be doing right now. He definitely shouldn't be going and trying to spar KSI after that performance, because if he can't hold up for 6 minutes, when they throw him in there with KSI, and we know KSI is one of the cardio kings in this YouTube shit, it's not gonna look good when they get into rounds 3 and 4, if it gets there, and they're going 3 minutes per, and KSI is just starting to ramp up. I doubt he makes that trip to London, because that would just be 2 L's stacked on top of each other, and I don't know how much more Tetris Adam Sala wants to play. Slim also fought. I know that people were wanting me to break this fight down. There wasn't much of a fight to break down. The first thing I noticed was that Slim put on some weight. He's gotten a little bit bigger, right? That will help Slim if he goes and fights some guys that do love that pressure forward, kind of bully you into the corner and throw shots their style. And obviously his opponent, they said he had MMA experience. I call bullshit, unless he meant like the UFC video game, because there's no chance. And this fight wasn't the most interesting, but his call out after kind of was, because he calls out 2 people. Gibb and Deji. Again, I don't know if I even want to see Deji fighting at this point until, you know, we see some real commitment to the sport from him, because Slim is committed. He's doing the stuff he needs to do. But the Gibb fight, that one is where things get interesting, because I do think Gibb's pace presents an interesting battle for Slim. Like, what happens when Slim does give up his range? What happens when guys are inside and he has to clinch up, or he has to find a way to dirty box his way out of that clinch? That is something I do want to see. I just haven't seen enough of Slim to know, you know, how he deals with any kind of adversity or any kind of resistance at all, really. Whereas Gibb has gone through the ringer, and what he did to Taylor Holder was very, very impressive. So yeah, I would lean toward Gibb, but I would like to see the fight. It'd be interesting. So like I said, there it is. Will Adam Sala go and spar KSI? Will Slim go and fight Gibb or somebody else? And who in the hell else wasted their money buying f***ing cocoa bean swap to watch this event, because it feels like I was the only one at this point? I don't have the answers to those questions or where the f*** my money just went, but I guess we'll find out.